Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new, welcome. And if you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for clicking on this video again. And as always, I'm just going in with my e.l.f. concealer and just placing this all over my lid, patting it in so I don't have any creasing. And I believe that was the color chestnut, by the way. Okay, so now I'm going to go into my Morphe 39A Dare to Create palette, and I am taking that plum purple shade, and I'm using this as a transition, and I'm putting it directly in my crease. And instead of wiping back and forth, I am just patting that color in and building it up to my liking. I did go back into my Morphe palette and I did grab this orange. It's like a burnt orange shade. I can't really explain it, but I'm just taking that color and I'm going to put that on top of that plum purple that I use. And this is just going to help to soften the crease so it's not so harsh. So I'm just going to take that color and put it on top of that purple and just blend it out. So now I'm just going back in and adding a little bit more purple to the crease. I do want to keep the crease dark, so when I cut my crease with the concealer, I'm able to see exactly where my crease is. So I'm just going back in and filling in all the spots that I feel like may have lost a little color. But other than that, I just want to keep it soft at the same time. So that's what I'm doing here, just blending all the colors together. So a little trick that has helped me over time when I started doing cut creases was to take my concealer, place it on the bottom of my lid, and look up like you guys just saw. And this is literally going to help you see exactly where your crease starts, or like where you would cut out your crease. It'll give you an outline. Okay, that's what I'm trying to say. So yeah, that was very helpful for me when I first started. Of course, you can go over your crease if you don't have enough crease space, but for anybody that is a beginner or someone that is learning to do a cut crease, that's definitely a trick that will help you, okay? Put it on the bottom of your eyelid, look up, and just follow the exact outline of where that concealer is, okay? I'm telling you, it'll help you, especially if you're a beginner. Okay, so now I'm just setting that concealer so that it won't crease. I'm not setting it with an eyeshadow. Actually, no, I think I am going to set it with an eyeshadow. I'm just going to take a nude eyeshadow color that looks exactly like the concealer, and I'm just going to place it all over my lid. Because the concealer is still wet, I don't want it to move, so that's why I'm going to set it with an eyeshadow. At this point, I didn't really know what I wanted to do with this look. I know I just wanted to use some chunky glitter that I purchased from the Makeup Goddess. So yeah, I'm just putting this eyeshadow all over my lid, and I'm setting the concealer so that when I get ready to place down the shimmer eyeshadow in my glitter, it won't, you know, it won't go everywhere. Alright, so now I'm going in with that plum purple shade from my Morphe palette, and I'm just going to buff this shade in at the end of my cut crease. You always want to start at the end of your cut crease, the end of your eye, and just work your way slowly towards the middle. So yeah, I'm just taking those two colors and I'm just blending them in together so I can create a flawless transition. You don't want to leave the ends how they are when you cut the crease, because it'll just be, no, can't leave it like that. It'll look too crazy. So just blend those colors in. Take your time doing this part until you get it up to your liking, okay? So I did go in with this burgundy shade from my palette, and I am adding that closer to the center of my eyelid, right after the purple. And this is just to help brighten up the lid and add a little color. As y'all can see, it's like a rosy burgundy color, and it's very, very pretty. So once that's done, I am going to go in with my NYX Glitter Primer, and I am just going to place that all over the inner corner of my lid where the concealer is. And I'm going to take this, it's like a shimmery gold pigment, and I'm going to put this all over on top of where I did lay down the NYX Glitter Primer. And this is just going to help the color pop more, but it also will help it stick so it doesn't move, okay? And it also works really good with glitter. So if you guys are looking for something that can hold glitter besides eyelash glue or anything like that, go get you some NYX glitter. So I did go down to my local Walmart and I picked up a makeup palette from Profusion Cosmetics, and the palette I picked up was called Mirage. It's a 35 shade palette, and y'all listen, do y'all see that pigment? Do y'all see that gold pigment? Yes, this is from a palette from Walmart, okay, and it was only $12. Listen, the pigment in this palette is actually really good. I was so surprised. I was so shocked to see that. So, listen, I'm going to do a video with this palette so y'all can see. You know, if you are a beginner and you're looking for a palette that's affordable just to start off with, I would suggest to go and pick those up. They have a few more, but I did grab one that was more neutral, but it also had some shimmers in it as well. So, yes, y'all. Now I'm gonna take my chunky glitter that I did purchase from Makeup Goddess on Instagram. You can go check her out. And I'm gonna take the gold chunky glitter that I have, and I'm gonna put that on top of the shimmery gold that I just laid down, okay? And I would suggest putting down a base, a shimmer color base, before you add glitter, because it'll just help the glitter pop more, okay? You don't want to just lay the glitter down, but you want to have some color underneath it so you can see it better, if that makes any sense at all. I didn't want a lot of glitter. I just mainly wanted the chunky pieces to place on my lid to give my lid a little pop, okay? So now I'm going to go in, and I believe this is the e.l.f. eyeliner in black, and I'm just gonna make a wing. Let me know if you guys want to see how I do my eyeliner and create my wings. I'll definitely shoot that video. So go down in the comments and let me know if you guys would like to see it, okay? Now I'm just going in to pop on some lashes, and I did purchase my lashes from my local beauty supply store, and my local beauty supply store does carry Minx, but lately I have been buying the iEnvy 3D collection, okay, and they're affordable. They run about $2.99 up to $3.99. It depends on the style that you want, but listen, I think I'm gonna give you guys a drugstore haul because I have found some gems in drugstores like Walmart, beauty supply store, even the Dollar Tree. So I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to go ahead and give y'all that, especially for you beginners, because I was there and I'm still, you know, getting into makeup and trying to explore into new things. But definitely when I was starting, I definitely was in the drugstore heavy, and I still am. I'm not going to lie, you know. We'll be right back. All right, ladies, so this is the complete look. I absolutely love it. I hope you guys do too. If you did, don't forget to leave your girl a like. Go ahead and comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Also, follow me on all my socials, and I will see you guys in my next video. So take care. Bye.